So in 2021, right where I'm standing, a neighbor's camera caught the final moments of 36-year-old Ashlyn Maddox. And she was dropped off here by a medical ride-to-care service. 2 hours after that, she was back here circling the area disoriented right before she fell unconscious. And the high temperature that day was 116 degrees. And this is 9 degrees above the previous record.
We are talking an extremely dangerous heat wave. And the reason for that is the folks in the Pacific Northwest and British Columbia are not used to this type of heat.
And Ashlyn died of extreme heat exposure. She lost consciousness just 50 feet away from her air-conditioned home.
But there's more to the story than extreme heat and heat-related illness. When Ashlyn died, she was found with a McDonald's bag and a drink that still had ice in it.
That's a clue about the last moments of her life. And what she did during those moments actually tells us a lot about how to make our cities more livable as temperatures set record after record.
So this is the route that Ashlyn would have walked to go get food at McDonald's. And you can tell that there's just a ton of asphalt, a lot of impermeable surfaces, a lot of traffic, a lot of cars.
We don't know for sure what happened, but if she did walk to that McDonald's, she would have likely been walking for over an hour along a very busy, very hot section of highway with very little shade. At that time, it was around 116 degrees at the Portland airport. But in other parts of town without many trees, researcher Vivek Shandis recorded a much hotter air temperature of 124 degrees.
We'll get into why that corridor was so much hotter than other places in the city, but first, a bit more about heat as the world warms.
We can identify two categories of cities. First, the already hot places like Phoenix, Las Vegas, and Miami.
These places that are already really hot and already sort of getting close to the limits of some of the ecosystems and people living there, we're shifting those temperatures hotter. And so people have to rely even more on things like air conditioning in order to make these places livable.
But how does the other category of more temperate places like Portland suddenly transform into one of the hottest places on Earth? The answer is a heat dome.
Normally, our weather systems are pushed from west to east by the jet stream.
But sometimes the jet stream develops large, wavy patterns or meanders, essentially trapping weather systems.
What happens when we get a heat wave is that we have one of these high pressure systems that basically stops moving. So it stops propagating towards the east and it becomes roughly stationary and just stays in one place. And if it's strong enough and stays in place for long enough, you can get these very extreme temperatures.
The trapped high pressure system acts like a lid, evaporating clouds and bringing clear skies. Normally, the moisture in the soil and plants moderates heat as it evaporates. But if the high pressure system stays stuck in place long enough, this moisture gets depleted and the sun's energy goes directly into heating the air and temperatures skyrocket.
The 2021 heat wave in the Pacific Northwest was one of the most extreme heat waves across the planet. There's a lot of scientific disagreement about this at the moment, but some estimates put it at an event that would, on average, happen once every 100,000 years. It broke the Canadian national record by 4.6 degrees Celsius. This was absurd.
There's growing evidence that climate change is slowing the jet stream and causing more meanders, like the one that caused the 2021 heat dome. What we do know is that we're seeing more hotter heat waves, especially where most of us live. Extreme heat is especially deadly in cities, and that's because of the urban heat island effect. And this is where our built infrastructure amplifies warming by around 2 to 5 degrees during the day, and up to 22 degrees Fahrenheit at night. That means heat-trapping aspects of our cities more than double the current level of global warming, making heat waves even more deadly. Big news. Weather just released our first TV show. Weathered Earth's Extremes is everything you love about Weathered, but bigger and better. We traveled all around the world to tell the definitive story about our changing weather and climate and how a better future is within reach. To support us and help us do more seasons, you can watch the series on your smart TV on the PBS app for free. You can also watch it on pbs.org at the link below. We put so much into this show, and we can't wait for you to watch it.